Tisztelt ünnepi szereplős, tisztelt hölgyeim és uraim! Köszöntöm Önöket a Szegedi Tudomány Egyetem nevében. Szokásunkhoz híven a Honoris Causa kitüntető címek átadásáig rendezvényünket angol nyelven folytatjuk. Honorable Ceremonial Senate Session, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Szeged, I have to honor to welcome you to our ceremonial Senate session. It is my special honor to welcome Professor Gábor Szabó, Rector of the University of Szeged, Professor Márton Vilmányi, Dean of the Faculty of Economics and Business Administration, Professor Judith Hoffman, Dean of the Faculty of Pharmacy, Professor Eva Jakab, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Law, Professor László Mucsi, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Science and Informatics, Professor Lajos Kemény, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Medicine, Professor Katalin Nagy, Dean of the Faculty of Dentistry, Professor Sándor Csernus, Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor István Marsi, Dean of the Gyula Juhász Faculty of Education, Professor Mária Barnai, Dean of the Faculty Health Sciences and Social Studies, Professor József Horváth, Dean of the Faculty of Agriculture, Professor Gábor Keszthelyi Szabó, Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Professor Ferenc Szecsüldi, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Music. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Szeged, it is my special honor to welcome our guests. Professor Gábor Kozma, Rector of the Ferenc Gál Theological College, Szeged. Professor Pál Ormos, Director General Biological Research Center, Szeged. Professor Imre Dékány, President of the Regional Committee of Hungarian Academy of Sciences. Dr. János Lukács, Chief of Police of Csongrád County. Dr. Gyula Lőrinczi, Attorney General of Csongrád County. Honorable Ceremonial Senate Session, I would now like to invite Professor Gábor Szabó, Rector of the University, to the podium.
Honorable awardees, dear colleagues, dear citizens of the University of Szeged. The day we are commemorating now is an event from 92 years ago when University of Szeged started its operation here in the city. It moved from the city of Kolozsvár-Kluzs to Szeged, and this very important event not only illustrates a stormy part of the history of Hungary, but there is much more to it. After all, you can ask, how can you relocate a university? What is a university? Are they bricks, people, all together? And I believe that whereas bricks, or better to speak, hardware is very important, I have no doubt that modern science cannot be done with a pocket knife and a screwdriver, but still, the university is people and institutional culture. And in that sense, you can, yes, you can relocate a university. We were very lucky in Hungary that at that time we had not only a minister of culture, but a real statesman, a politician of international stature, Count Kuno von Kebersberg. He knew very well that university is people in addition to bricks. He was the one who really laid the groundwork for a successful university, which I hope we now are at least trying to do our best to carry on this very important and very precious heritage. If you consider what a university is, you can very easily see that perhaps in addition to church, university is the most stable creature of human culture. But there are very big differences between religion and university, or church and university, because most religions have sacred texts that you cannot touch. University is something that is changing. I would even compare universities to the most admirable character of the human body. We know that basically the majority of the individual atoms and molecules that are in your body are replaced in every 3 or 4 months, but still we are still living in the meantime. And that, I think this is what universities do and did over the millennium, that the only thing that was really continuous is continuous changing. But still, you may ask, is there anything that is really overarching the millennium? Yes, there is, I believe. There is an undisputable common denominator, and this is excellence. Excellence in teaching and excellence in science. That is the lingua franca of the universities all around the world. And there is something else. If you consider the first universities, they served several countries at the same time. So another thing is mobility and exchange of people and ideas. And I believe these are the two fundamentals that we are also commemorating today, since our awardees are doing something, did and keep doing something that is excellent according to its own measure. And also most of our honorary doctors are our friends, colleagues from abroad, which also signalizes the living context of the University of Szeged with our partners abroad. And actually this is very important, since I sincerely believe that our destiny is to be, and we have to strive to do so, to be an internationally recognized research university. And I keep telling this because of, even in spite of some, I believe, temporary financial difficulties, which I don't want to comment upon in this nice day. But I'm pretty convinced that our path is very well defined. We know where we want to be. We go that direction and keep going. And of course, it is very important that all of you, citizens of the University of Szeged, and of course, our friends and colleagues from other institutions helping us, all of us, it's a huge teamwork, but the rules are more or less laid. We know them. I hope we know also how to win. So let's go ahead and win together. Thank you for your attention.
Ceremonial Senate session, ladies and gentlemen. In accordance with the decision of the Senate of the University of Szeged, the Doctor Honoris Causa degree can be awarded to scholars who carry out outstanding scientific work recognized internationally and who have had continuous, lengthy connection with our university, which have led to common, internationally recognized achievements, thus enhancing the good reputation and appreciation of our university. Therefore, it is my special honor to welcome Stanley Nettle, professor at the University of Montreal, Thomas Bremer, professor at Martin Luther University Halle-Wittenberg, Peter Kleinewudde, professor at Heinrich Heine University Düsseldorf, Heiko Vogler, professor at Dresden University of Technology, who are present here and our Senate session, to accept the Doctor Honoris Causa degree of the University of Senate. Honorable Ceremonial Senate Session, ladies and gentlemen, in accordance with the decision of the Senate of the University of Szeged, the title Senator Honoris Causa can be awarded as a recognition of any outstanding public or artistic work or significant moral or financial support to our university or one of its units. Awarding this degree enhances the good reputation of the university. Therefore, it is my special honor to welcome Marius Rajka, professor at the University of Medicine and Pharmacy, Viktor Babes, Timișoara. Violet Harasti, professor at State University of New York at Buffalo School of Dental Medicine, who are present here in our Senate session to accept the Senator Honoris Causa degree of the University of Szeged. Honorable Ceremonial Senate Session, under recommendation of the Faculty of Medicine, we award the Doctor Honoris Causa degree on Professor Stanley Nettle. I would like to ask Professor Lajos Kemény, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Medicine, to present the scientific and academic activities of Professor Nettle.
Stanley Nettle is one of the foremost researchers in the world area of cardiac electrical activity and disorders of heart rhythm. His laboratory has provided some minor insights into the workings of the human heart, explaining how the electrical system of the heart works at molecular level and why life-threatening rhythm problems happen and how to prevent them. His research group uses a wide range of methods, including cell biophysics and imaging, molecular biology, biochemistry, in vivo physiology, mathematical modeling, sophisticated animal models of human disease, many of which his lab invented, and clinical trials in patients to gain insight into the detailed operation of the cardiac electrical system in health and disease. Some of his most important work has been performed in close cooperation with the pharmacology department of the University of Szeged, with the intimate help and personal friendship of Dr. Julius Popp and András Varó, along with many other younger colleagues. His studies have not only led to a much better understanding of how the heart works and why it sometimes develops serious problems, but also new ways of treating and preventing heart rhythm problems, which are now used around the world to improve heart health and fight disease.
Professor Stanley Nettle, the rector and the senate of the University of Szeged, have awarded the Doctor Honoris Causa degree on you. I would like to ask you, Professor Stanley Nettle, to accept their handshake. We award the Doctor Honoris Causa degree to Professor Thomas Bremer. I would like to ask Professor Sándor Csernus, Dean of the Faculty, to present the scientific and academic activities of Professor Bremer.
In addition, Professor Bremer, Professor of the Institute of Roman Studies, will be presented in French. La coopération scientifique et éducative entre le professeur Thomas Bremer et le département de littérature comparée a commencé il y a une vingtaine d'années, d'abord dans le cadre des programmes TEMPUS et Erasmus, ensuite, et à partir de l'an 2000, le professeur Bremer a pris la co-direction d'un groupe de recherche international d'études doctorales axé sur les phénomènes interculturels créés par les universités de Halle, de Brno et de Szeged. Il participe activement dans le programme doctoral de l'Université de Szeged, donne régulièrement des conférences et assure l'accueil de nos étudiants à l'Université de Halle. Le professeur Bremer a une réputation internationale très solide dans le domaine des recherches, des études comparées des cultures latino-américaines, de la civilisation européenne du XVIIIe siècle et des éditions critiques. Collaborateur de l'Académie de Berlin, professeur depuis 1994, de l'Institut d'études romanes de l'Université Martin Luther, dont il a assuré la direction pendant plusieurs années. Le professeur Bremer a été également le doyen de la faculté de philologie entre 1988 et 2003, ensuite vice-recteur chargé des affaires éducatives. Depuis 2000, il a été nommé membre du groupe de travail éducatif et du multimédia du ministère du Land de Saxe-Anhalt, et le responsable de la formation permanente des enseignants de ce même province. Il est également co-rédacteur de la revue Tibaldone, spécialisée dans l'étude de la littérature italienne contemporaine, et membre de la rédaction de la revue Nauerlandicon. Auteur de nombreuses études et de livres scientifiques, des éditions critiques, collaborateur des encyclopédies, le professeur Bremer est également rédacteur de plusieurs publications de très haut niveau et membre d'un groupe de recherche spécialisé dans l'édition électronique des textes littéraires.
Professeur Bremer, the rector and the senate of the University of Szeged are ready to award the Doctor Honoris Causa degree to you and confirm it by their handshake. I would like to ask you to put on your gown and accept the degree. Professor Judith Hoffmann, Dean of the Faculty of Pharmacy, to present the scientific and academic activities of Professor Kleine-Budde.
Professor Peter Kleine-Budde was born in Gelsenkirchen in 1958. He graduated as pharmacist in 1983 in Hamburg and passed his PhD degree in 1987 in Kiel. He worked as pharmacist at Beiersdorf Company in Hamburg, then he was the head of the bulk production at Glaxo Company in Bad Oldesloe. In 1997, he got the habilitation in pharmaceutics and biopharmaceutics, and he became associate professor at Christian Albrecht University in Kiel. He worked as guest lecturer at the Royal Danish School of Pharmacy in Copenhagen. Between 1998 and 2003, he was a full professor for pharmaceutics at Martin Luther University in Halle-Wittenberg, where he was the dean of the Faculty of Pharmacy. Since 2003, he is a full professor for pharmaceutics and head of the Institute for Pharmaceutics and Biopharmaceutics at Heinrich Heine University in Düsseldorf, and since 2010, he is the head of the School of Pharmacy. Since 2011, he is a member of the Academic Senate of the University. His main research field is the development and characterization of solid dosage forms, especially dry granulation, extrusion, coating, quality by design, process analytical technology. He has authored and co-authored more than 170 refereed papers, 8 books, book chapters, 4 patents, more than 300 Congress contributions, about 180 invited lectures. He has supervised so far 44 PhD theses. Between 2003 and 2010, he was the president of the International Association of Pharmaceutical Technology. At present, He is member of the Powder Working Party and Group 12 at ED Cohen. He is also deputy chair of the German Pharmacopoeia Commission in section of pharmaceutical technology. In 2004, he became fellow of the American Association of Pharmaceutical Scientists. He is member of the editorial boards, a number of important journals in the field of pharmaceutical technology. Precisely 12 years ago, he started collaborating with colleagues of the Department of Pharmaceutical Technology, led by Professor Piroska Szabó-Révész. This long-standing fruitful collaboration resulted in 10 scientific papers, 18 Congress contributions, and 5 PhD theses, 3 Hungarian and 2 German. Moreover, 8 researchers from our university visited his laboratories, and altogether they spent more than 12 months. 6 researchers of Professor Kleinbühl's group also visited our university and spent more or less time here doing research work and presenting lectures. Professor Kleinbühl is visiting professor, hold a course for PhD students in the frame of our postgraduate teaching program. We admit the importance of this cooperation and hope that it will continue in the future.
Professor Kleinbühl, the rector and the Senate of the University of Szeged are ready to award the Doctor Honoris Causa degree to you and confirm it by their handshake. I would like to ask you to put on your gown and accept the degree. Doctor Honoris Causa degree to Professor Heiko Fogler. I would like to ask Professor László Mucsi, Vice Dean of the Faculty, to present the scientific and academic activities of Professor Fogler.
Heiko Fogler studied computer science at the universities of Darmstadt and Aachen in Germany and graduated in 1981. Afterwards, he did his PhD studies under the supervision of Jost Engelfried at the University of Enschede and in Leiden in Netherlands. And then he received his PhD degree in 1986. Moving back to Aachen, he successfully completed his habilitation in 1990. From 1991 to 1994, he was an associate professor at the University of Ulm, and in 1994 he became a full professor for Foundations of Programming at the Technical University of Dresden. His research topics include the theory of three automata and three transducers. Recently, he has turned to machine translation as well. Besides teaching and research, he took part in the administration of his faculty as a vice dean and dean. For 10 years, he was the chairman of a doctoral school. He visited the University of Szeged for the first time in 1987 and began a joint academic venture with the three transducers group. Since then, he has visited the Informatics Institute about 20 times and received as a guest several members and students of the Institute. These visits and joint work resulted in several research projects and about 15 joint publications, including a book and a handbook chapter published by the Springer Publishing Company. In addition to research work, he has given lectures to the students in Szeged at all levels, and he also became a teacher of the Doctoral School of Informatics. He is one of the two organizers of the workshop series called Weighted Automata, Theory and Applications, which has been a forum for presenting the results of joint research work with his colleagues from Szeged. Some invited speakers from Szeged regularly present tutorials and lectures at this workshop. With his above activities, Heiko Fogler has established a smoothly working professional cooperation between the university, between the Informatics Institute of the University of Szeged and the Informatics Faculty of the Technical University of Dresden.
The rector and the Senate of the University of Szeged are ready to award the Doctor Honoris Causa degree to you and confirm it by their handshake. I would like to ask you to put on your gown and accept the degree. I would like to ask Professor Lajos Kemény, Vice Dean of the Faculty of Medicine, to present the academic and scientific activities of Professor Rajka.
Professor Marius Rajka, the current rector of the Victor Babes University of Medicine and Pharmacy, Timișoara, Romania, began his scientific work in the Department of Histology, where he works today as the head of the didactic and research groups. Passion for pathology was harmoniously combined later with clinical activity. Professor Rajka, becoming specialist in urology, practiced as a surgeon in several urology departments in Romania and abroad. He introduced morphocytochemical methods for the early diagnosis of the urologic tumors that are now worldwide recognized. Parallel with his clinical work, he continued his research in histology, and since 1995, he is the head of the histology department of the Victor Babes University of Medicine and Pharmacy in Timișoara. Professor Rajka is an internationally recognized researcher and clinician with highly developed skills in morphology, pathology, electron microscopy, immunohistochemistry, and molecular techniques. He is the founder and the head of the internationally recognized angiogenesis research center in Timișoara. The cooperation between Professor Rajka and the University of Szeged started many, many years ago and is based on mutual friendship and common scientific goals. As vice rector and then the rector of the Victor Babes University of Medicine and Pharmacy Timișoara, he encouraged collaborative actions in all academic fields with the scope of developing a strong regional partnership. With every passing year, more and more doors were opened, widening the area of bilateral cooperation, involving staff and student exchanges, establishing new directions in scientific research, developing the PhD and medical curriculum, and being always oriented toward the new generation.
Professor Marius Rajka, the rector and the Senate of the University of Szeged are ready to award the Senator Honoris Causa degree on you and confirm it by their handshake. I would like to ask you, Professor Marius Rajka, to put on your gown and accept the degree. I would like to ask Professor Katalin Nagy, Dean of the Faculty of Dentistry, to present the academic and scientific activities of Professor Parasti.
Senate, ladies and gentlemen. Professor Violet Ibolyaharaszti, whose professional and scientific career started here at the Faculty of Dentistry at the University of Szeged, has been working as a professor at the Department of Restorative Dentistry of the internationally well-known university at Buffalo, utilizing the knowledge she's attained at our university. She's a member of several international scientific associations, including the American Dental Association, the American Association of Dental Research, the American Academy of Periodontology, and the American Academy of Cosmetic Dentistry. Although Professor Harasti has been working as a professor overseas, she cherishes a close scientific and educational relationship with her alma mater and participates actively in the undergraduate and postgraduate education as guest lecturer at her faculty. Thanks to the strong ties between the Research Institute in Buffalo and the Faculty of Dentistry at our university, some of our undergraduate and postdoctoral students have had the chance to spend 1 to 3 month study visits to Buffalo at the invitation of Professor Harasti with the purpose of broadening their scientific knowledge. As an outcome of the collaboration between the two faculties, joint articles have been published, and at present, there are 2 mutual scientific research projects currently underway. The title Senator Honoris Causa expresses our gratitude and appreciation towards Professor Harasti for showing exceptional commitment towards her alma mater and honors her for her distinguished merits and exceptional personality.
Professor Violet Harasti, Director and the Senate of the University of Szeged are ready to award the Senator Honoris Causa degree on you and confirm it by their handshake. I would like to ask you, Professor Violet Harasti, to put on your gown and accept the degree.
Thank you.
Tisztelt ünnepi szenátus ülés! 2013-ban az Egyetem Szenátusa Pro Universitate díjat adományoz Erdélyi Ágnes asszonynak, az STL Móra Ferenc Kollégium igazgatójának. Fekete Éva professzor emerita asszonynak, a Természettudományi és Informatikai Kar biológus tanszékcsoport élettani, szervezettani és idegtudományi tanszék professzor emeritájának. Gábor Erzsébet professzor emerita asszonynak, a Mérnöki Kar Élelmiszermérnök Intézet nyugalmazott egyetemi tanárának. Hetesi Erzsébet docens asszonynak, a Gazdaságtudományi Kar Üzleti Tudományok Intézet intézetvezető egyetemi docensének. Nagy Ferenc professzor úrnak, az Állam és Jogtudományi Kar Büntetőjogi és Büntető Eljárásjogi Tanszék egyetemi tanárának. Simonka János Aurél professzor úrnak, az Általános Orvostudományi Kar Traumatológiai Klinika egyetemi tanárának. Pro Universitate díjban részesülhet azon személy, aki az egyetem oktatás-kutatás eredményeiért jelentőset tett, illetve az egyetem vezetésben és annak fejlesztésében kiemelkedő érdemeket szerzett. Mindemellett aktívan részt vett az egyetem hazai és nemzetközi intézményi, szakmai és gazdasági kapcsolatainak fejlesztésében, a már kialakult együttműködések ápolásában vagy újabb létrehozásában. Felkérem Erdélyi Ágnes kollégium igazgatóasszony, hogy rektor úrtól a díszoklevelet és az emlékérmet szíveskedjék átvenni. Kérem Fekete Éva professzor emerita asszonyt, hogy rektor úrtól szíveskedjék átvenni a díszoklevelet és az emlékérmet. Felkérem Gábor Miklósné professzor emerita asszonyt, hogy szíveskedjék rektor úrhoz fáradni és átvenni a díszoklevelet és az emlékérmet. Kérem Hetesi Erzsébet intézetvezető docens asszonyt, hogy rektor úrtól szíveskedjék átvenni a díszoklevelet, valamint az emlékérmet. Felkérem Nagy Ferenc professzor urat, hogy rektor úrtól szíveskedjék a díszoklevelet és az emlékérmet átvenni. Ugyancsak felkérem Simonka János Aurél professzor urat, hogy szíveskedjék átvenni rektor úrtól az emlékérmet és a díszoklevelet. A Szegedi Tudományegyetem egyetemi tanácsa döntése értelmében a professzor emerita emeritus cím a Szegedi Tudományegyetemről nyugdíjba vonult egyetemi tanárnak adományozható. A cím adományozásának feltétele a Szegedi Tudományegyetemen, illetve a Jogerőd Egyetemen legalább 10 éven át egyetemi tanárként végzett, kiemelkedő, iskolateremtő oktatói és kutatói tevékenység, amely az oktatói-kutatói utánpótlás biztosításában is megnyilvánul. Ez a tevékenység adott esetben jelentheti új tárgyak, szakterületek meghonosítását, illetve az oktatott diszciplína tankönyvének, jegyzeteinek továbbfejlesztését, újrafeldolgozását. A professzor emerita, emeritus cím tulajdonosa nemzetközileg is elismert tudományos és tudományszervező munkát kell végezzen, amit gazdag tudományos publikációs tevékenység, sikeres tudományos pályázatok, hazai és külföldi egyetemekről kapott elismerések, kitüntetések is igazolnak.
Tisztelt Hölgyeim és Uraim, kedves vendégeim! Szép hagyomány egyetemünkön, hogy azokat az oktató kollégákat, akik hosszú időn keresztül öregbítették egyetemünk hírnevét, nyugdíjba vonulásuk alkalmából professzor emerita, emeritus kitüntető címben részesítjük. A mai napon hat kiváló kollégánk, dr. Fekete Éva professzorasszony, dr. Hetényi Magdolna professzorasszony, dr. Szente Magdolna professzorasszony, dr. Brazovics László professzor úr, dr. Hannus István professzor úr és dr. Hatvani László professzor úr részesül ebben az elismerésben. Felkérem dr. Fekete Éva professzorasszonyt, hogy rektor úrtól a kitüntető címet szíveskedjék átvenni. Felkérem dr. Hetényi Magdolna professzorasszonyt, hogy rektor úrtól szíveskedjék átvenni a kitüntető címet. Dr. Szente Magdolna professzorasszony a kitüntető címet a mai napon ünnepségünkön egyéb elfoglaltsága miatt nem tudja sajnos átvenni, viszont felkérem dr. Blazovics László professzor urat, hogy tegye ezt meg, fáradjon rektor úrhoz és vegye át a kitüntető címet. Felkérem dr. Hannus István professzor urat, hogy rektor úrtól a kitüntető címet átvenni szíveskedjék. És ugyancsak arra kérem dr. Hatvani László professzor urat, hogy szíveskedjék rektor úrhoz fáradni és átvenni a kitüntető címet. Tisztelt ünnepi ülés! A Kristó Gyula Alapítvány kuratóriuma Kristó Gyula díjat adományoz Neumann Tibor úr, a Móra Ferenc Múzeum munkatársa és a Szentesi Koszta József Múzeum kinevezett igazgatója részére. A kiemelkedő jelentőségű középkorkutató Kristó Gyula professzor emlékére alapított díjat azon egyetemünkön foglalkoztatott fiatal oktatók, kutatók vagy egyetemünkön medievisztika doktori képzést végzett, de nem a Szegedi Tudományegyetem foglalkoztatott oktatója, kutatója kaphatja, aki a középkori magyar históriában érdekelt tudományok témakörében kiváló eredményt ért el. Felkérem Mag Ferenc professzor urat, a Kristó Gyula Alapítvány kuratóriumának elnökét és rektor urat, hogy a díjat szíveskedjenek átadni, továbbá felkérem Neumann Tibor urat, hogy vegye át a díjat.